Hello guys, this is Amit Jarula. Today we are going to discuss one problem of geotechnical engineering. This problem was asked in civil engineering gate 2018 in afternoon session. And the problem is three soil specimens, soil 1, soil 2 and soil number 3, each 150 mm long and 100 mm in diameter, are placed in series in a constant head flow set in a flow setup as shown in the figure. The suitable screens are provided at the boundaries of the specimen to keep them in intact. The values of coefficient of permeability of soil 1, soil 2 and soil 3 are 0.01, 0.003 and 0.03 cm per second respectively. One figure is given and they have asked the value of H in setup is. Let me prepare the figure, then you will understand what is the problem actually. The figure is given. For a constant head setup, constant head permeability test, constant head is actually one laboratory test which we use for calculating permeability in the laboratory. There are other methods to calculate the permeability, but in the laboratory we use this method, constant head, for granular type of soils, and for very fine soils we use falling head. So here you can see, because what happened, the permeability of a granular soil actually is more. That's why we have to use, we have to keep the head constant. Continuously we pour the water. Now, let me prepare the figure first. The total head difference is given 560 mm. This is the final head, this is the initial head. The head loss is given 560 mm, total head loss. And somewhere here, they have given soil number 1. Here soil number 2. And here soil number 3. This is your soil number 1, this is soil number 2, this is soil number 3. The length of each soil sample is 150 mm. And one more thing that we should notice here, the length is same and the cross-sectional area of each sample is also same. For this and for this soil, the cross-sectional area is same. If the cross-sectional area is same, and we know the discharge will be same, discharge at every section will be same, because of continuity, discharge is there. If the discharge is there, cross-sectional area is also same, velocity is also same. If I put a discharge equal at the final values, and for this particular location where I have to calculate the value of H, so I will be able to calculate the value of H. Let me explain how to put it. First of all, you see here, if the water is going from high head to low head, definitely it will pass the soil number 1, it will pass the soil number 2, and then it will enter in soil number 3 and it will pass the soil number 3 also. If it is passing this through the three soils, means it is a stratified soil sample where there are three layers, and you can see the flow of water is normal to the number of layers, correct? If it is normal to the number of layers, is perpendicular to the number of layers, what I can do? I can calculate the equivalent permeability or average permeability. The formula is known to me, summation of H divided by summation of H by K. This value is the coefficient of permeability when the flow is normal to the number of layers. Now you see here H, 150, 150, 150. So total is 450. The coefficient of permeability for sample 1, sample 2 and sample 3 are given in centimeter per second. And the values are 0.01 cm per second, 0.003 centimeter per second, 0.03 centimeter per second. The value of h are known to me, value of k are known to me, I can calculate the average k value. So let me put all the values. 150 divided by 0.01 plus 150 divided by 0.003 plus 150 divided by 0.03. So the answer is, not answer, for this k average value, 0.0064 centimeter per second. Now the discharge is same, so can I put the discharge at any level? The average level discharge, the total discharge is equal to, see what I am going to do actually, in the constant head I know Q is equal to K into H A by L. This I have written from constant head permeability test. Now what I am going to do here, I can put K average. This K average happens with respect to the total head loss. So total head loss is capital H suppose, into cross-sectional area is A, divided by length, total length of the soil sample. So total length of soil sample 150 plus 150 plus 150, 450. So that is 450 should be equal to, because it is the value of discharge, discharge will be same everywhere. So for this location we write K, for K3 it is 0.03, correct? Now into H, that is the head difference which we have to find, into H into cross section area A divided by length 150, correct? So everything is with me, I can calculate the value. And the value will be calculated in mm, because they ask the value of H in mm. So here the value of H in setup is, four options are given, 0, 20, 255, 40 and 560 mm. So you can calculate the value of small h. The capital H value I know, it is 560 mm. The cross sectional area is same for all the type of soils, everywhere the cross sectional area is same, so A to A is cancelled. K3 I know, the value of K3 is equal to 0.03 centimeter per second. In mm, if you want, we can put 0.3 mm per second, the value of K3. Now H we have to find, other things are known to me. So value of H, here we are getting 40 mm. If we put all the values in same unit, we'll be getting the value of H, that is the head difference after passing the soil number 2, is 40 mm. So for this problem, answer is B. Answer is B. If you have any doubt or any problem with this question, so you people are free to call us. This is our contact number. Thank you so much.